The world has become so fragile that we cannot subject the Earth to the tortures we can now inflict upon it. We are actually tampering with the climate of the Earth and with the very atmosphere that we breathe. Not only are we piling in more and more carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, but we are chopping down the forests of the Earth at a great rate. And these problems are life and death problems. They go to the root of the viability of the planet itself, making the Earth a lot less livable. We are facing problems that transcend nations. When we talk about the greenhouse effect, we're talking about something that affects the entire Earth. Human beings are facing the same problems. It is important that the world get together to face the problems which attack us as a unit. The problems with the ocean, with the atmosphere, with the population, with pollution. The only way we can solve a problem is by a human solution. A cooperative solution. There's one thing that is biologically certain about the human species is that it is a human species. One species. Who is going to lead in the direction? Never can we sit back and wait for miracles to save us. Miracles don't happen. Sweat happens. Efforts happen. Thought happens. And it's up to us to help. Have all that happen.
Free Experiencer Project. I'm an experiencer since childhood. I had my first experience at about the age of six, and I've had some other sort of check-ins over time. And for the last 8 years or so, I've been in direct telepathic contact with my team. I'm a Pleiadian starseed. So I wanted to give you just a bit of information about you and places where you can find many things that I've written. I thought that showing you sort of my world online would be better than just a talking head video. So I did a lot of work on the website Quora for a few years, starting in 2011, and I was a top writer in 2013 and 2014. But I definitely try to get this information out of the echo chamber as much as possible. So I'm a social scientist, so you'll see that a lot of the topics that I have answers in are related to the social sciences, but I have some related to spirituality and scientific research and popular culture and other things. But I have a lot of answers in the extraterrestrial life category, and I've really done a lot of work to try and combat the scientific truth embargo and this problem we have of all of the crazy questions that people still ask and the crazy answers that people still give regarding issues of aliens and all of these things. So it's really pretty silly, the conversations that are still being had. So I do as much as I can to answer these questions in a way that's, you know, sort of rational and reasonable, and utilizing my knowledge of, you know, the state of the UFO and experiencer phenomena over many years now. So I also publish extensively on Medium. I'm the co-founder of the Disclosure Activists, and we have a publication called We Are Not Alone, the Disclosure Activists, and we have a lot of articles here by a number of different authors. We're happy to include new authors and new points of view, and really enjoy doing that. So if you're interested in contributing to our publication on Medium, you should definitely let me know. We also have a website, which is disclosureactivists.org. We've tried to make it a little bit more dramatic and a little more clean and streamlined than some of the other disclosure information, because we're working really hard to get this information out of the echo chamber. The public's going to need to be prepared for the things that are coming up. So this is our website. We have a petition going to the UN, except it's not really needed anymore. The UN is apparently already in talks and collaboration with delegations from the Galactic Federation of Light or the Earth Alliance. So that's happening, but we still have a movement, and we have a disclosure manifesto here. I also, on our Medium publication, have an ET manifesto, which is a bit different, but a document that you might be interested in seeing. But definitely, as far as, you know, looking for evidence and understanding the evidence that we've accumulated, and that I guess I've sort of vetted from my experience or point of view, our website is a good place to go, and it's a good website to show people who, you know, don't understand just how much information there is about this phenomenon, and who are sort of relying on skeptics and debunkers, you know, to understand the sort of state of things. So we have just about everything in here. Sightings and, you know, scientific possibilities, sort of understanding a convergence of science and spirituality is one of the things that I'm personally very interested in. So I would suggest checking out our website just, you know, to understand that. We're also published on Pionic, which is a very interesting publication, which is, again, a convergence of science and technology and spirituality and philosophy and the future and weird things. And but, you know, from a very credible, scientific, rational discourse point of view. There's other stuff that you can find about me. We have some videos. The Disclosure Activists have videos. I have my own video channel as well. And so if you're interested in video content, you can also find plenty of that sort of stuff in interviews. I actually recommend this one with Galactic Connection because it really illuminates my story more broadly. So very nice to meet you all, and welcome to the revolution of mind and heart.